My Gavan and Melanine, and well met indeed. I'm Arik here, Garla-Jerithan, the head of the modding team behind Divide and Conquer, and welcome back to the mod Divide and Conquer as we continue on as the Kingdom of Gondor. Now, before I begin, I apologise, but also I don't apologise. I'm going to start with something that's reasonably deeply personal. And don't worry, it's good news, but it's going to start bad, but it's going to get better. My sister, one of three, I have three sisters, one of them was recently diagnosed with breast cancer. I haven't spoken about this in any of the videos because I didn't want to, full stop, really. I just didn't want to. But as recently as last week, she's had an operation to have the offending lump removed from her breast. And this week we've got results back and it seems that she is actually now cancer-free. She's going to have to go through chemotherapy and potentially radiotherapy as well. But the reason that I'm mentioning this is that she wrote a reasonably short but very entertaining little blog, about one a week over the course of this whole ordeal. And now that she's through it and she's out the other side, she really wanted some sort of, I don't know, she just wanted to share her experience with others in the hope that it might help someone. And obviously she's my sister, so I'm going to, of course, try and assist in that endeavour as much as I can. So in the link below, sorry, I've hit the microphone. In the link below is a link to the blog that she wrote throughout this whole process. As a little side note, I mean, I'm absolutely thrilled that my sister has essentially beaten cancer, but never counting chickens before they hatch. I mean, she has still got to go through chemotherapy, radiotherapy. It was quite an aggressive cancer. She's only 27, so we don't have any family history of it. But whilst my immediate family, my siblings, my aunts, uncles, grandparents, all of that, none of them have had cancer, my wider family has been horrendously touched by cancer. So I don't want to go into details, but rest assured that my family is very, very well aware of what cancer can actually do in the worst case. And not just very well aware, on three separate occasions we've had to deal with what cancer can do in its worst case. So it was a massive shock to our family when one of us finally was diagnosed with it. The chances were always there. There are six of us in the immediate family. So please do just spare a few moments to read the blog. And if possible, leave a little bit of feedback as well, because I know that she would appreciate that a great deal. And so I just wanted to mention that before we get any further in. So my sister's called Megan, I'm called Edward, we're both called Megan and Edward Gill. And so do have a read of her blog in the link below and leave some feedback if you will. And of course, if it's something that you can empathise with or something you know firsthand as well, then please do leave your experiences on the blog as well to let her know. And if it helps in any way, then do just mention that. So I did just want to say that, and I'm not too bothered that it takes as long as it takes to say it. So there you go, that's out of the way. So we're thrilled as a family that this has ended, essentially. We've still got to go, as I say, through chemo and through radiotherapy. Right, so with that gone, that passed, I shall continue with Gondor. We're fighting in Brandir's Pass. We're about to defeat Captain Muzgash. Angbor, the champion, arguably our nation's greatest warrior, is about to rid this small little land of orc filth. Now, speaking about reasonably personal things, another thing that I've mentioned nothing about because I didn't really want to jinx it, but I can now say is that as of yesterday, you're watching this on Friday, I recorded it on Thursday, so on Wednesday of this week, I discovered that I successfully got a job as a paralegal for a law firm in the sleepy little village of Berkhamsted in western Hertfordshire. And I am absolutely overjoyed. I am over the moon. It is such an opportunity for me, and I'm really, really pleased, really thrilled. So the only thing that this might mean is that now that I'm going to be working in a normal job and not one that sometimes finishes at 2 o'clock in the afternoon, my recording schedule may well suffer. There are going to be a lot of times where I'm going to be asked to work late, and I can't imagine I'm going to want to do a recording at 8 o'clock at night having worked all day. So just as a bit of a heads up. So number one, I'm pleased and I'm thrilled. But also number two, heads up, it may affect the recording schedule. But so overall, it's been a good news week. Cancer free, and we finally got me a job that isn't mind numbing and not progressing my life in any way. So to all of you out there who are job hunting, I implore you to endure, stick at it. The chances will come. Now, if we turn our attention back to this, though, we attacked them, so I can't actually just sit on that hill and do sod all, and there's a strong possibility that it's going to bug out like an absolute I was going to swear then, but I don't really like Sir. They might be on top of this hill, and if that is the case, then we're screwed. Massively screwed. We've got an army of archers as well, and I didn't check what their army composition is like. I was going to say something else as well. What was I going to say? Can't remember. Yeah, you go with them. Cav. Oh, look how depleted this army is. Angbor has paid dearly. Oh, let's check it. Right, no, they're totally attackable. Brilliant. Right. Their army's not very big, so we should be an easy victory, but it does look a little bit like they're going to come and meet us. I hope they don't. The other thing I was going to say, I do remember, is you might catch some auditory noise in the background to sound a bit like a strong wind, because currently in England, we're being racked by what we have called Storm Doris. And it's just horrifically windy out there. And unfortunately, I have terrible windows in my 100-year-old house. And I don't want to do that. I don't want to do that. Stop. No, everybody stop. And the windows aren't sealed properly, so the air gets through. And it makes very loud noises. So I apologise if that is picked up at all. I tell you what as well I'd like to talk about is I am recently come into the market for a reasonably well-priced yet very effective what I believe are being called now as ultra books. I thought they were called notebooks, or I think the Chrome one is called a Chromebook, and they're all essentially versions of the MacBook, but with Windows operating systems. Although I believe the Chromebook has a Chrome operating system. And I'm in the market for one. So if you've got one that's not particularly expensive and you can really recommend, then do let me know, because I'm hoping to get one. Now, I obviously, in my day, they used to just be called laptops. But now apparently they are called ultrabooks. And the one that I've got my eye on is, well, not the one, it's more of a brand. I quite like the Asus, or Asus, however you want to call it. I've run away from them, now I'm running to them. I quite like the Asus Zenbooks, I think they look pretty cool. I don't want a MacBook because I don't think Apple's operating system is very user-friendly and it's very hard to get used to after Windows, and I think it's just rubbish. There is that. I much prefer Windows. I'm a Windows fanboy, and I shall be. I also quite like the HPs. I must also confess that I am massively driven by my eye rather than my head. And if I like the look of something, I'm way more likely to buy it, even if it's worse than something I don't like the look of. Which is a failing on my part. I appreciate that. But right, here we go. We've got someone suckered in. Some Orc Maulers. We can actually start fighting this battle. Down they go. How many have we killed so far? 7%. We're not in very good range here, are we? And this is going to be an awful position to be in if it does come to this fight here. They're avoiding us, though. Look, they're avoiding us completely. I think it's probably time to start moving, really. We shouldn't just hope that this is going to carry on. I don't really want them shooting these. Although the AI is wigging out hard. No, there they go. They're coming. They're coming! They're coming! For the glory of Gondor! Maybe they're trying to skirt around to get the cab. I don't know. Either way, we'll reposition. Bring them into a slightly more favourable location. I've just had a mint, but I'm going to drink some blackcurrant juice and it's going to taste vile. Oh no, not too bad actually. I think they might be organising a retreat. That or they are just killing themselves. In the modding world, those of you who favour Darwinian, those of you who like Darwinian, may be pleased to hear that Hummingbird has decided to recolour the Thorn units to be purple instead of red to match the Darwinian purple theme. Oh, they're reshaping because he's over there. All right, mate, you come up here. So all of the red Thorn units are going to be purple. Now, unfortunately, this change has come about after I did the new Darwinian overview, so it won't be reflected in the overview, which is a shame. But, can't win them all. Units bugged out all over the place. We killed 30%. Our arrows are running out, though. Our arrows are running out. That they're curling around. They're trying to get those. Why are you so interested in that unit? You guys go out. Give them something to remember us by.
If we continue like this, we will smash the enemy.
Javelins.
For the glory of Gondor.
Let us prepare for this war.
Only half the enemy force remains. Behold,
oh, that was the world's easiest victory.
It's time to press the attack.
Interesting that they just seem to have... Oh, no, there we go, they're off. I tell you what we should get do, is we should get a new one of these symbols so that there's one for the enemy and one for you, so that you can just have a quick look over at the side and see, oh crap, my general has died. And rather than which general has died. I'm thinking it could be the same for every faction. So there's the culture-specific one is that your general has died, because that was clearly a Gondorian tomb. And then maybe if we just did, like, crossed swords or something, that's the universal UI symbol that the enemy general has died. I think that could work in our favour. Because I always get frustrated when you look over there and you're like, which one has died? Should I be worried or should I not be worried?
This is a clear
Oh,
victory.
Dear. Mordor. What did you do to yourselves? That's outrageous. 199 kills, Ithilien Rangers. Well done. Oh, no, I can tell you what that is, because that is Turin Turambar, basically, essentially the main character of the Silmarillion in many ways. And he kills his own friend in a kind of fit of frenzy. And then when he realizes what he's done, he goes a little bit mad. And that was the moment where he realizes he's just killed his own friend. To learn more, you can read The Children of Húrin, or in Flawless Sindarin, Nan I Chin Húrin, which is the story that is in its own book, actually, Kill Them All. And it's a standalone book. It was released by Christopher Tolkien afterwards. But it is a story from the Silmarillion. Right, Angbor, then, you go down there. Let's do it. Let's be a bit bold, shall we? Be bold, be strong. For all the Christians amongst you. What do we do with our own lands, though? How are we doing in the West? In the West? That's not a word there, eh? How are we doing in the West, eh? Captain of Gondor. Hannon is returning to Londgallen to meet up with more troops. Oh, I can feel the breeze coming through the window. That's bloody freezing. Bloody nippy. The road this morning was just covered in trees. Covered in branches, twigs, fallen leaves, you name it. It was littered with it. Right, I think we're going to need to return to assist Fanwilond. So, train some defenders to stay. We're not going to want to take everyone. But we'll leave behind you, and we'll leave behind you, and you. Everyone else, go and get rid of Rasul.
Let us set up camp here. Ready your weapons.
Harad should hopefully be a little bit more occupied with the fact that in one turn, the City of the Fountain returns to its rightful owners. Oh, look, you can train as well. Where are we getting all this money from? Don't even know. And how are we doing up here? Somebody pointed out that Eisenmouth and Isengard, although their question was a little, I didn't think they understood quite as that much, but I'm not meaning to single anyone out as idiotic or anything, but Isengard is just means guard of the river Isen. That's where the name comes from, and the river Isen. And Eisenmouth just means mouth of the Isen. And they asked me, how can they be the same thing if Isengard means guard of the river? How can I, and which I found a bit odd, and that's because Isen is Rohirric for Iun, F-E on the periodic table. So Isen Mouth is just Iron Mouth, and it's just the Iron River. And it flows either into the Angband, or it becomes the, or it is, or its other name is the Angband. I can't quite remember, it's on a map just up there, which is also just means iron. So it's just iron, basically. Right, I think that's everything that we can do. What do we think of the Gondor Gate holding out? Not sure. Rasul can attack that in one turn, and he's not going to meet any resistance. I think we just need to end the turn and suck it up. Oh, and the army we've left there is not going to hold off against his army.
Can you not tell friend from foe?
Oh dear, we're not going to be done here, are we? But for now, I think we just need to end turn. End the turn, sir. Let us hope. Sorry, sniffing. I think I'm coming down with a cold.
Aha! The Haradrim are not happy with our assault of the City of the Fountain. They will attack us. Hanad and Tamruben. Hanad brings some camels, filthy camels. 2 units of cavalry, and then a couple of pikes. So he's got a very cavalry-heavy army. And we've got a very light and archer-heavy army. Oh, dear. And Tamruben brings death. Himself is really the only thing that's going to be a threat out of that lot. Right, okay. I see your challenge, and I raise you a victory for Gondor. How is it that much... Why is this not more in our favour? We outnumber them. We've got better troops than them. With Gondor. Ah, Smaug there. Look at the death of Smaug. An artist's representation. You can see the black arrow sticking out of his chest. Start deployment, men. Right, they're going to try and flank us. It's the only thing the AI does when they're cavalry-heavy armies. But with any luck, we can stop that. Oh, I can't really see a good hill. I think where we are is probably the best hill. Oh, I don't know. This is a bit more hilly, isn't it, when you consider outside the lines? I've seen quite a few comments moaning, basically. But I'll allow you that. Saying that the cheesy tactic I used in the Angmar campaign, where I sent my troops to the edge of the map and held them there to attack the enemy straight away and won that outrageous victory. There were a few people who were very displeased with this method, and they were not happy that I did it. However, quite a few people then jumped to my defense saying, yes, it's very cheesy, but at the moment, Arrakis's Angmar campaign hangs by such a slim thread that if he doesn't use every single conceivable tool to his disposal, he will lose. Like, the campaign is basically a matter of time, and it's just whether or not we can do some cheeky victories here or there in order to balance it in our favor a little more. But I don't think it will. I am concerned that the campaign may well result in our demise. Now, what I am thinking of doing is stretching you out a bit further, moving you slightly further down, so that we can get the javelins a bit more like that. So that they block the flanks a bit more, but they're still protected by the front line. And then we'll keep our cavalry in position to try and stop any of flanks. They don't really have any archers, and we do, so our archers are going to be key here. Kill what you can. Oh, pikemen, yeah. Kill them if you can. They're waiting for their allies to join up with them, aren't they? I'm very pleased with this choice of attack. The pikemen are I'm more concerned with the pikemen than I am with the camels. Camel riders. Grunting away to themselves. As the enemy gets closer, our arrows get only more accurate. Ah, they've got their own archers coming in there. That's annoying. I hate cavalry archers. I hate them. Hate. The camels are coming very wide. Let's send our own camels. Camels are good against cavalry, though, aren't they? But I'd rather lose militia than our general. Speed it up a bit. Go on, throw your javelins properly. Yeah, there we go. Good men, good. The pikemen have been about halved in their size. The Benins haven't even had to get involved yet. Change your position around a bit. Move off to the side. Prepare, men of Belagia. That's why you don't think the Lebenin Marines and the Lebenin Guardsmen look the same, because they have different colour schemes. And they have a strap across their chest, and of course they have the winged helmets. But if you look at them from the back, he's got red and blue patches on the line and a grey side on that side with a brown tunic. If we continue like and this, they've got grey on that side with a slightly lighter colour, but the same tunic. It's the strap of the Marines that differs them, and their helmet. They are based off each other, I assure you. We've got heavily favourable stats at the moment. Our archers have still got plenty of arrows and none of them are engaged in melee yet.
Archers are kind of like the silent killers, really. You don't really pay attention to them. You don't really notice what they're doing. And then all of a sudden, you've won, and you go to the stats at the end, and you realize your archers killed more than anyone else. But those Black Snake Guard are going to be a problem. Big problem. We're losing more. We need to find a way to make our cavalry as effective as theirs. Don't really have a way, but you might as well come and start doing some flanking attacks. Everyone, come off of defense. Feel free to push out. Should have put you into shield wall, really. If the enemy's going to push us, then we'll push right back. They've got a tatty line. This side is very broken up, though, isn't it? Come, men. Shift. Attack there. Go there. Go, 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 go. Ah, the Black Snakes are moving off to counter us. They smell our weakness. Why are you guys not throwing javelins at anything? Come on. Curing of the keys. Don't fall now. Go on, get a throw, get a throw, get a throw. You useless... Oh, no, there we go. I knew the fear of a weak insult would get you off.
The battle is very much in our favour. Victory will be ours.
Get your men out of there. What we need, of course, as ever. No! Buggers! They are badly bloodied. They've got us.
They have lost half their men.
They have cut through our militia cav, and now... Go, my Athelian Rangers. Are there any camels? No, come on. Don't play the fool with me. 60% of the enemy has died, but then 40% of us have died. There you go. Now you got them trapped. Where can we best use you? Out here. Hit those lancers. How are our lines holding? You're not doing too badly at all. You are falling. You're falling. And you are holding.
The enemy are badly bloodied. They have lost half their men.
His camerades are coming down there. Men. Good charge, men of Gondor. Good charge. Keep that strength. Yes, flee, you cowards.
We will smash the enemy.
It seems like, from what I can tell from just reading comments, that in the faction vote that will come when two of these campaigns have ended, or when all of these campaigns have ended, sorry, I'm going to do the factions all at once again. In the faction vote that will come, it seems at the moment that it's going to be neck and neck between Rune and Isengard. Isengard seemed to be the evil version of Gondor in that everybody wants to watch Isengard campaigns. I was always very reticent to do a Gondor campaign because it's the most Let's Play covered faction in the Lord of the Rings Total War arena. So there's that for one. And, well, that's basically it. It's been done so many times. Gondor has been done so many times. But then it turns out there's a reason why Gondor has been done so many times, because it's just so damn popular. And Isengard seems to be the same. For every one person that says Isengard's been done too many times, we don't want to watch that, there are always about three or four people who say, yeah, we do. It's really interesting. I like this YouTuber. I like watching Isengard. Ergo, the two together is some sort of heavenly divine mix. Much like Angel Delight butterscotch and milk combines to make one tasty dessert. Right, our major threat at the moment comes in the form of the captains, the two Black Snake Guard. There's seven of them over there, but they're being dealt with quite nicely. But these 11 can still cause some serious damage, especially when they charge into the back of your troops like that. But everyone is now fighting. This is going to really cost us. I didn't think Harad would be this good. Their pikemen have been killed, though. Gondor militia, get out over there. You guys go out over there.
you guys could do a bit of a flanking move. Yes! Who's gone down? Hanad has fallen. And the routing starts. Sorry, that was a lot of S's. It always picks up badly, doesn't it? There we go. It's all over. They're running.
It's time to press the attack.
The only people still fighting are those Black Snake Guard up there. So now we're just waiting for them to die. Don't throw javelins at them. Enemy general, and it's over.
We are victorious.
Oh, that wasn't a very good victory at all. 1,049 Gondorians just lost their lives in the walls of the City of the Fountain. Ithilien Rangers, 242 kills. Well done. 100 kills ahead of the nearest. Very well done indeed. Very, very well done. Oh, no, there you go. That's anyone's guess. Who the hell is that? He looks reasonably Dunedain-ish. Dunedain? Kill them all. No mercy. Oh, Fanwilond. Oh, I'm not even sure I'm going to... Oh, we get two units of defenders. We're going to do it. We can do it. We can do it. Come on, come on, come on. This will be the greatest battle of our time. It thinks that's one for one. Look at that. There are almost three times as many of them as there are of us. And it thinks it's one for one.
Yes, my lord. Preparing the men to attack.
We can do it. Now that, I would guess, would be... Is it Fingolfin that fights Morgoth? I believe it is. The fight between the two of them. Doesn't end well for Fingolfin. Spoiler alert. Gondor flag in my version still tainted with that white arrow. Right. I don't think trying to hold the gate is the best way forward. Because the enemy will force their way through. But then they'll shoot arrows at us as well. That's the only thing. I think having them both next to each other... is going to be our best bet. You guys throw javelins over the top. You guys throw javelins over the top. And you seven. I don't know. Stand your ground. Yeah, you have to endure some arrows while the enemy smashes down the gate. But if we're getting a little bonus because we're fighting on top of that hill, we're going to have javelins raining down into the enemy from above. Well, he's only going to throw one javelin. Four of those, those are just his little entourage. But they will shoot arrows at us until they break through.
The enemy are battering down our gates.
There we go, look, they're coming. They're not doing very well, though. They're shooting into the buildings.
The enemy's ram is through our gates.
And then once they meet us in melee, I think they'll stop the bee. I told you not to move, actually. Pretty sure I told you not to run down the hill like that. But, you know, each to their own. Are you already out of... Jesus. But if I take you off of defensive, then you'll just go mental. Right, I'll tell you what we'll do then. Take you off of shield wall altogether. Fan out. Hold them in check. Right, you guys, I am going to ask you to go on a bit of a bender, really. There's no point using you. You're dead, but you guys come. Get our captain out of the way. Get him hidden behind the building.
Yeah, the battle is very much in our favor. Victory will be ours.
See, the battle may be in our favour, but the one thing that the game can't really take into account is that we are very much outmatched by the Naru and Aru Household Guard. And they might be able to hold off the Corsairs for some time, but they won't be able to stop the enemy bodyguard. So I think Umbar will win this fight. Unfortunately, I can't see any way that they won't. Although a nice little flanking attack there at least takes some people down. Sadly, right into the jaws of the Naru and Aru, but it gives us back control of the gate for a time, so we'll at least get some more people. The banner of Umbar waves in the front lines, and it's brought down. Come on, push through.
If we continue like this, we will smash the enemy.
The more we kill, the easier the retake battle will be. Stout men of Gondor defending the lines. Is that the actual enemy captain? I think that might be. Yeah, it is. Oh, he's horrendously out of position. Only like two, an arrow are with him. The rest are over there, killing off one pikeman still exists. Go on, son. Get involved, lad. Get involved. Go on, someone knock down the... He wears the helmet of the Dark Numenoreans. He's spitting in our face. Haven Guard also have that helmet, but a much shinier version. Although it looks an awful lot like the wolf helmet from Skyrim, but with the wings above it. The helmet that the companions wear. Sorry, I've used a Skyrim reference again. Strike me down, God, I am not worthy of life. How dare I compare a much-loved and enduring fantasy realm, such as Lord of the Rings, with such a base, casual fanship feature as Skyrim. Heaven forbid I compare two features that make for an easy comparison and allow the message to get across to those who would otherwise struggle to interpret what I'm saying. Heaven forbid. Right, now the crux of the issue. If that general dies... As I say so much, I apologize, I am a broken record. But if someone could just bop him on the head, cleave his head from his shoulders, kick it around a bit, and then start spitting on people near to him, then I think the enemy might run away. And we've won. However, if he can endure, the Household Guard will slowly beat us on that side.
The tide of battle seems to have turned against us. We must act and
He's
halt this turn
defended
of events.
By the just sheer size, the number... Oh, the pikeman man's gone down. No. Oh, and our army's starting to waver. Now is the chance. Come on, someone get him. Someone just knock him down. He's down. They're not focusing on him. They're getting, like, stun-locked. Come on, anyone. Someone. Bop him on the head. No. No. He's cut the head. Clean off there. He's no, but the man's not even facing you. You coward! Ah, oh, they're running. It's all over, everyone. It is all over now. There we go. We killed so many of them, though. That's really good stats. But then our men will turn and fight to the death once they reach the square. We'll get to kill even more of them. And they're now going to shoot themselves as well, which is always good. Yeah, you keep firing arrows into your own men. Yeah, you keep doing
something
that.
Changes in the course of battle, for defeat seems
oh, I've just seen three Corsairs go down to flaming arrows. Maybe today will be that most fortuitous day where the general gets a stray flaming arrow to the head and burns alive. And our men walk across the smouldering ruins of his once foul body. City. I think our general might have gone down because I can't do the horn. Oh, no, there he is.
Our foolish general has...
Our men have fought...
Oh, dark day.
We've dark day indeed.
On the field of battle.
I would not call that a crushing defeat. Come on. Where do I need to send my complaint letters? That someone in an office is reading these stats and deciding whether or not they're crushing defeats or not. And I challenge their interpretation of that battle. That was a great victory. We killed twice as many as we lost. They are going to be such easy prey to our faction heir when he strolls across the mouths of the Anduin and bats down the door of Fanwalond. Oh, if you're suing for peace, then I can tell you you're not going to get it. No, you're just trying to bribe me. Fanwalond has been taken by the Corsairs. Never did I believe I would see this day.
Protect the blood of Numenor.
And yet here it is. Oh, and look at that. We're going to take it back straight away and you're going to die. Never pass up an opportunity to recruit. I'll take both of those. City of the Fountain, what can you give me? Low tax rate, that's what you can give me straight off. Oh, you've got ages before you get anything. Go with an archery range. Can't retrain anything. Never good, never good. Any threats elsewhere? They are coming for Tir Thoros. That's all right. We knew that was going to happen. And Dol Guldur are coming for Henneth and Noon. Brilliant. Get some troops. How many is the free upkeep? Isn't it 5, I think? Three from that, three from that, six. One, two, three, four, five, six, there you go. And all trained in one turn. Well, three turns by the end, but... Money-wise, I mean, we got all of that straight away. Oh, goodness gracious me, Mordor. Just know when you're dead and back down. Oh, look at that army. I mean, just literally look at that army. It's all trash. It's literally an army of Mordor's trash. Durthang itself doesn't really have too much. Apparently Durthang is another buggy battle map in my version of the game. Not, I stress, in your version of the game, which is much later than mine. I'm gonna stick you. Have we got a general in there? Oh yeah, we might be able to win that. But that is all going to be a tale for another day. It's certainly not today. I shall end the episode there. So, thank you very much for watching, if indeed, friends, you have. And please do, as I said at the beginning... Oh, I forgot about you. Yeah, go on. Beat them to it. Go on, beat them to it. Do have a read of my sister's blog about everything that had a little ordeal there, and leave some feedback if you can. And that's about it, really. So until we speak again, dear friends, Navarna den peramad melunin, and farewell.